Doo-dee-doo-dee-doo. Here I come, back from my travels with my wonderful fancy suitcase. Let's take a look in my suitcase and look at my socks. So we open up our suitcase and we look for our socks. Oh my goodness! There are no socks in here! There's a tape recorder! Okay, we're looking at the Realistic Model 505A auto-level portable tape recorder, which was sold originally in 1972 by Radio Shack. Now, obviously, Radio Shack did not make this entire collection. Someone else did that, and they used this case to carry the tape recorder, extra tapes, cables, and a microphone. This machine traveled through Texas in 1976 to AA meetings, and it recorded the remarkable stories of people in recovery. And this machine has a very special surprise to reveal. Now, for those of you who are disappointed because you didn't get to see my socks, there you go. There's my socks. I purchased this machine from a seller on eBay. It arrived DOA as expected, and the problem was that the belts inside had deteriorated and turned into that gooey, tar-like mess that sometimes these belts turn into. So I had to completely clean the machine and replace the belts and got it back into functioning order. It's a very nice machine. We're going to take a look at the inside of it, and we're also going to see a problem that this machine has which can never ever be repaired. But before we go there, let's take a look at how the machine actually works. And we have rewind, stop, play, fast forward, and record. There is no pause control. It has a tone control, a volume control, a selector here for the monitor so you can monitor recordings, and it has a 3-digit tape counter. This machine is AC bias. It has a good quality amplifier on it. And basically, it's very well constructed. Now, let's take a look at the ins and outs of the machine. Now, in the front, we see the speaker here, and the front-mounted speaker is an oval speaker. On the side, we see that we have a microphone, remote input, a line input, and an external speaker output. On this side, we see there's an AC input for a special cord that comes with the machine, which means you don't have to have an adapter of any kind. This also will run on 4D batteries. It's a 6-volt system. We're going to make a test voice recording using the microphone that came with the unit. So we put the microphone switch in the off position, press record and play. We don't have to adjust anything on the machine. It's automatic level control. The only thing we need to make sure of is we turn the speaker monitor off so we don't get feedback. Press our reset buttons so we know where the zero is, and off we go. Testing 12345, testing 12345. This is a test of the Realistic Model 505A auto level portable tape recorder. This is the end of the test. Push the switch in the off position, push stop, put the switch back on, rewind back to zero, and play it back. Testing 12345, testing 12345. This is a test of the Realistic Model 505A auto level portable tape recorder. This is the end of the test. You see, it makes a very, very fine voice recording. For rewind, the rewind table here will slide over and press against the shaft on the motor. The original ring was some material that turned into a sticky, gooey tar, which got smeared all over the inside of the machine. I had to clean that out with ammonia. Let's look at rewind. Notice how the table moved over and touched the motor. It's very slight motion. So not a lot of tolerance there. That's why this had to be a very special ring. Now for playback, or fast forward, There is a belt here that goes from the motor around the capstan flywheel, and then there is a second belt that goes from the capstan flywheel around a friction clutch mechanism under the take-up table. Now, in play, this lever here, that controls the strength of the clutch. So in play, this part of the lever moves it up just about halfway, and then for fast forward, it moves it up all the way. Let's take a look at that first in play. So you see how it only lifted a little bit, and the take-up table is spinning, but it is not resisting the capstan. So good slippage there, no problems. For fast forward, watch this lift much higher. You see how it came up much higher? Now, as I hold this, it's really fighting with the capstan. And you can see that in the way the belt is trying to buckle. In addition, the machine has leather brakes. There is also a permanent felt brake that presses against the feed table to keep the back tension. Now, does anything look odd to you? Notice how this belt is vibrating or warbling quite a bit. The reason it's doing that is the flywheel for the capstan is buckled. Look at the shadow here between this plate and the belt. Watch as I turn this by hand. You see it moving? Very close now. It's moved at least 2 millimeters in this direction. And now it's close again. And now it's 2 millimeters away. The flywheel is warped. The capstan shaft itself is made of steel, and it is perfectly straight. The flywheel appears to be made out of some sort of a zinc material. It's either cast or turned. When I took this machine apart to clean it, I took the whole capstan assembly out, cleaned it, and I examined it very, very carefully under my super magnifying glasses. And I could see that there were cracks in the flywheel itself. Now, the only way that metal could have cracked and fractured is because of tension that was created when the thing was put together. So there has to have been a manufacturing defect, which was not obvious in the beginning, but became obvious over time.
Thanks for listening to Dream Angels, the theme from the magical Dream Angel Oracle Divination Program, brought to you by Clydesight Productions at www.clydesight.com/D-A-O.
Thank you for watching this video on the Realistic 505A Auto Level Portable Tape Recorder from 1972. And a shout out to Cool Dude Clem, Cassette Master, Bad Edit Pro, Dr. Cassette, and the many fans of Clydesight on YouTube.